have allowed us to live our vision, to dream, and to make a difference. And for that, I'm so very grateful for everything that they have done for us. To Grandmaster Sardone, thank you for all of your help, all of your contributions, all of your support, without which we couldn't be where we are today. And to Deputy Grandmaster R.J. Kessler, we're looking forward to an opportunity to working with you as well as we continue our goals in the neurocognitive space. We have so much work to do, and with all of you, we can help make a difference in humanity. Tonight, I'm actually really delighted to introduce also a few other colleagues who are here with us today. Susan Bartkowiak, who is our Interim Director of Administration. My developmental team, who are somewhere selling things and soliciting, I think, I don't see them in their seats. Anthony in the back here, David Stiles in the front here. They will be coming around to talking to you. So how did we get here? You heard Alvaro talk about the Institute as a cardiovascular research institute, and that's true. We are a cardiovascular research group. We have, for 60 years, excelled at cardiovascular science, especially in one particular area, electrophysiology, which is sudden cardiac death. So 2 years ago, when they brought me on and they said, the sky's the limit. You can do whatever you feel is the most important research. And so we started. We've expanded cardiac research. We do everything from pediatric heart disease to end-stage heart failure and everything in between. But most importantly, we had the opportunity to go beyond the cardiovascular space. And that gentleman, Pat Mbimbo, was instrumental in allowing this to happen. He was the inspiration that drove this research area. There were two other things that happened also. And you mentioned, I don't know if I can say God, the master of the universe, makes a difference. So there were two things that happened in addition to meeting Pat. The first of which was when I moved to Utica, I met one of our premier cardiologists, Mike Kelberman, who runs actually the Kelberman Foundation in Utica, which is a school for autistic children. And while I went to meet with him to discuss collaborations for the cardiovascular science that we were doing, we ended up talking about, was there any possibility that the MMRI could do autistic research?